Hey guys, today I'm going to talk about some of these Tillotson clone carburetors that I purchased online. Now, I'm going to be using these. This is a FULIN, F-U-L-I-N, okay. But it looks like a Tillotson, so you know it's a pretty good copy. And I'm going to be using one of these on this upcoming part 3 build I've got on this Ducar 212 engine. And today I was just checking these out and figuring out which one I'm going to use. And since I'm not going to spend a whole lot of time in the video talking about these carburetors individually, I thought I would make a separate video so, you know, anybody that's interested in them can check them out and see them a little bit more than they're showed in the part 3 video, which is coming soon, by the way. It's got this little rubber grommet thing. Now, these are actually made for chainsaw carburetors. So that rubber grommet normally would stick through the case, you know, kind of protect the screws a little bit. Before I get too pull happy and bend my adjustment screws, I'm going to go ahead and just remove those just to be safe. And yeah, it looks like the spring is what was hanging it up. But that's okay. And that's the low adjustment. You have a low adjustment and a high adjustment. Now I'm going to take both of these out. And you got to remember, and I have to remember here, to make sure I keep those separated because they have a different taper on the end of the screws. The low is a different taper from the high. So if you swap holes, you know, you can mess up your carburetor. And we don't want to do that. But now the low adjustment, it's marked. See, L. L on the front and H in the rear. The low adjustment, that controls the fuel flow at idle. Kind of like a pilot jet on the Mikuni clone carburetors we were fooling with here a while back. And, you know, you don't have to take this little rubber grommet thing off. If you're running one of these, you could leave it on there. But I'm going to go ahead and pull mine off. I like to be able to reach back there and grab the screw. That way I don't need a screwdriver. But I'll just run through real quick. We'll do a preliminary adjustment. This is going to be the first start. And we'll do some more fine-tuning once I get one of these on the engine, you know, in part 3. But yeah, you just close it off, and you know, when it stops, then back it out. Now, they want you to back the low out 3/4 of a turn. I always back mine out 1 turn. And sometimes a little more. But Tillotson on the HL series, you know, they want you, that's what the factory recommends. But you know, what they do and what I do is maybe not exactly right. Now this one, 1 1/4 is what they normally want you to do. But I start mine at 1.5. And that should be a good adjustment just for the first startup. And once it's started up, then we can do the final adjustment. Now, whoa. This one says Tillotson on it, right there, Tralee, Ireland. Or Tralee, however you guys pronounce that. I don't want to offend nobody. Made in Ireland. Huh. Well, I wonder if that's true. I hope that's true. And that, wow, this just popped right off. Huh. And the retaining springs on those screws are silver, not black. Yeah, I'll go ahead and run this one up. Now this is the low. Just run it up till it stops. You know, don't put any pressure on it after it stops. And remember, they want you to go 3/4, but I'm going to go 1. Actually, I think I went a little bit over 1 on that low. All right, on the high, half a turn, 1 turn. That's where they want you to go, 1 1/4, but I'm going to go 1.5. All right. Man, I'm liking this carburetor. Now, these Tillotson carburetors, you know, they don't have a float bowl. This is a pump diaphragm type carburetor. And that little hole there, yeah, you got to make sure you use a gasket too and not block that off. That requires a special intake, or you got to drill a vacuum release for your relief for your intake there if you use a regular intake. But it's got to have be able to put get vacuum to that hole. And that'll work that diaphragm so it can pump. And the other side of this thing is just clone bolts to the clone head. Now, this is the air filter adapter I bought. This one's a little small. This one's for a two-stroke carburetor. But, you know, I'm going to turn the inside out a little bit on the lathe and kind of open it up so I can go ahead and match it up. Yeah, not a bad looking little carburetor. Now the FULIN, okay, that's on the left, and the Tillotson, the actual Tillotson, what it says, is on the right. Now this is going to be difficult. I've got to try to open both of these up. I need two hands to hold the carburetors and two fingers for the throttle. Okay, there's the FULIN on the left. Tillotson on the right. Well, I'm blocking, can't see it, but anyway, there it is. Okay, now the, sorry guys, I get it up there and there we go. Now stay open. I did it again. Okay, well anyway, I'm noticing on the right, on the carburetor on the right, the Tillotson carburetor, it's got a larger venturi. It's got a much larger venturi. That's the keeper. That's the one I'm going to put on the Ducar 212 build. And I don't know why they say different things. I don't know why one of them says Tillotson and the other one says FULIN, because I ordered those both through the same link. And now I don't know what they'll cost at the time when you watch this video, guys, but what I paid was a little over $13. Well, probably 14 something with tax each with free shipping. So, you know, I thought it would be worth it to, you know, check out a couple. And it looks like we got about a little over 1 inch. I think 1 inch, 200 thousandths on the intake side here, the butterfly side. What do we got here? And about the same, yeah. 1 inch, 1,000. I bet, you know, it's just a 1 inch bore. That's. And the butterfly, yeah. Well, that doesn't make sense. Why would they have the same butterfly and then throttle bore and then end up using a smaller venturi on this other one? Yeah. Okay, well, I'm liking this. I'm well satisfied that, that I've got my money's worth in this one. These things aren't cheap. Especially if you buy a name brand one, you know. That's, and this one may be a Tillotson, it may not. You know, it says it on there, and as long as it works, I'll be satisfied with it. But, you know, $13-$14, hey, I'm not complaining. And again, this is just for the guys that wanted to see a little bit more on the carburetor I was using. That's why I made these separate videos. But that's all I got for today. Thanks for hanging out with me. We'll see you next time.